What if we could prove mathematically that reincarnation is possible? Or that one day we will all be back on this earth, and that everything we have done, everything we have experienced, will repeat itself? In today's episode, we'll try to answer to these questions from a more scientific perspective. The concept of reincarnation is at the center of many religions, but it poses also questions that go beyond faith. The German philosopher Nietzsche, for example, created a whole philosophy by bringing the concept of reincarnation to the extreme. He assumed that everything in the universe is destined to repeat itself, over and over again. That means, for example, that there will be a moment in the future where I will be doing this video again, and you will be watching it again. Not only a second time, but an infinite number of times. In a loop that we cannot escape. Philosophers call this loop eternal return. So, back to our question. What does the science tell us about the possibility of an eternal return? Can we prove it mathematically? A potential answer to this question can be found in the recurrence theorem, formulated by the French mathematician Henri Poincaré at the end of the 19th century. In this theorem, Poincaré proved that if we wait long enough, everything eventually goes back to the way it was. Let's make a concrete example. Consider a room with only one molecule inside, and let's make a screenshot of its current position. Then, we follow this molecule as it moves within the room. The Poincaré's theorem ensures that if we wait long enough, sooner or later, the molecule will be back at its starting position. The idea behind is that the molecule occupies a finite volume of the space and that the space available is limited. So, essentially, there are only so many places the molecule can go, and eventually, even if it were to sweep every inch of the room, it has to go back on itself. And if this applies to one molecule, then it also applies to many molecules. We might need to wait more time, but eventually, also in this case, there will be a moment where all the molecules will be at the same position they were at the start. And if it works for the molecules in a room, it also works for a larger system, like the molecules in a building, or a planet. Well, then why not for the solar system, or even the whole universe? There are a couple of conditions that need to be satisfied for the Poincaré recurrence theorem to apply. First, that we wait long enough, sometimes very long. For example, if we consider the molecules inside one room only, it may take hundreds of billions of years to reobserve a certain state. This is already longer than the current age of the universe itself. And the second condition is that the system we are considering must be bounded, limited in space. Now, the molecules in a room are indeed a closed, bounded system. But what about the universe? Is the universe a bounded system? Well, on this, scientists don't have a precise answer. Not yet, at least. If the universe keeps expanding indefinitely, then the space is unbounded, and the Poincaré theorem won't apply to the universe. But if one day scientists were able to prove that the universe does not expand indefinitely, but it goes through cycles of expansions and contractions, then in a very distant future, everything we are living now is going to happen again, almost exactly the same way. Got excited? Well, don't be. If this was true, then life itself would have a completely different taste. In fact, this concept of eternal return sounds more like a prison than like a real reincarnation. Imagine being condemned to repeat over and over again every single moment of your life. Not once, twice, but an infinite number of times, for the whole eternity. Every choice, also the little ones, would haunt us forever, and the responsibility behind every choice we make would be unbearable. And this ends today's episode. I hope you could find here some food for thought. And if you're interested in more of these videos, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.